Welcome to this video lecture on fluid dynamics. So in the previous chapter of fluid kinematics, we have seen that the velocity and acceleration were the only important things that need to be considered in fluid kinematics. And also, we are not considering the forces which are causing the motion. Now in fluid dynamics, it is the study of motion of fluid considering the forces causing the flow. The behavior of fluid flow is analyzed by Newton's second law of motion, which is net force is equal to mass into acceleration. Now let us see what are the various forces which are acting on a fluid when it is in motion. So first is the gravity force, which is due to the weight of the fluid. This second one is the pressure force, which is due to the external pressure difference between two points. Next is the viscous force, which is due to viscosity. Next is the turbulent force, which is due to turbulence of flow, which is due to momentum exchange between layers. The next is the surface tension force, which is due to cohesion between molecules. The next is the compressibility force, which is due to elastic properties of fluids. So if a certain case of fluid motion is influenced by all these forces, then as per the Newton's law of motion, the equation may be written as mass into acceleration is equal to net force, and in that net force we can see all this, that is Fg, which represents gravity force, plus Fp, which represents pressure force, plus viscous force, which represents Fv, which is represented by Fv, Ft, which represents turbulent flow, Fs, which represents surface tension force, and Fc, which represents elastic force or compressibility force. Now in some cases, if the fluid is incompressible and depth of flow is sufficiently large, then the above equation becomes like this: m into a is equal to gravity force plus pressure force plus viscous force plus turbulent force. The above equation is known as the Reynolds equation of motion. It is being used in the analysis of turbulent flow. If the flow is laminar, then in such cases, the equation becomes m into a is equal to Fg plus Fp plus Fv, which is gravity force, pressure force plus viscous force respectively. The above equation is known as Navier-Stokes equation. It is used in the analysis of viscous flow. Now, if the fluid is ideal, that is having no viscosity, surface tension, incompressible, then the equation becomes m into a is equal to Fg plus Fp, that is gravity force plus pressure force. The above equation is known as Euler's equation of motion. So it is used in the analysis of steady, incompressible and flow of non-viscous fluid. Now the next is Euler's equation and Bernoulli's equation. The Euler's equation of motion along a streamline. So in this equation of motion, the forces due to gravity and pressure forces are only considered. So we have seen that in the previous slide only. Whenever we are considering in only two forces, that is gravity force and pressure force, then it is known as Euler's equation of motion. So the final equation of Euler's motion, we are getting it like this as dabba p by rho plus g into dz plus v into dv is equal to 0. Now from this Euler's equation, Bernoulli has derived his equation. So Bernoulli's equation is obtained by integrating the Euler's equation of motion, and we get finally this equation as p by gamma plus v square by 2g plus z is equal to constant. So this is the Bernoulli's equation. Now the Bernoulli's principle, what does the Bernoulli's principle tells us? That when the velocity or the speed of the fluid increases, the pressure in the fluid decreases and vice versa. So this is the Bernoulli's principle. Now what was the statement of Bernoulli's? The statement of Bernoulli's was like that in a steady flow of an ideal fluid, the total head of any particle is constant along a streamline. The total head of any particle is constant along a streamline. So now the total head of any particle is the sum of pressure head, velocity head and datum head. Now the total head is constant, that is the pressure head plus velocity head plus datum head is equal to constant. Now this is the important statement of the Bernoulli's theorem. So now assumptions made in Bernoulli's equation. The first assumption is that the gravity force and pressure forces are only being considered. Next assumption is the flow is steady and continuous. The next assumption is the fluid is incompressible. The next assumption is the fluid is non-viscous, that is the fluid is ideal. Next assumption is the flow is irrotational. The equation is applicable along a streamline only. And the final assumption is the velocity is uniform throughout the cross section. Now there are some limitations also for this. We'll be seeing the limitations of this Bernoulli's equation. First one is that the practically the fluid is not ideal. So hence, due to the no slip condition, the velocity at the fixed boundary is zero and it goes on increasing away from the boundary. That is, the velocity across the section is not uniform. And the second limitation is that in addition to gravity and pressure forces, some forces like viscous force is also involved in the motion of fluid. Hence, modification in the equation is being made. So now we'll be seeing what are the various modifications in the Bernoulli's equation. So first is that when the fluid passes from section 1 to section 2 and there is loss of energy, then the Bernoulli's equation is P1 by gamma plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 is equal to P2 by gamma plus V2 square by 2G plus Z2 plus loss of head. So which is the most important modification or which is the most important equation? The next is when an energy head is being added like a pump between section 1 and 2, then the Bernoulli's equation is like that. P1 by gamma plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 plus head supplied by the pump, which is equal to P2 by gamma plus V square by 2G plus Z2. Now, what are the applications of Bernoulli's equations or the Bernoulli's principle? We have seen that the Bernoulli's principle, what it states that as the velocity of the fluid increases, the pressure decreases and vice versa. And on this principle, there are some devices which are being made on this principle. So these are venturi meter, orifice meter, nozzle meter, pitot tube and rotameter. So these are some of the applications of Bernoulli's principle. Now the first application